Learning how to add titles to your edit is an essential thing to know. Let's hop into Final Cut and have Nick teach us the ins and outs.
Titles are a great way to give viewers more information, whether in terms of names, dates, or locations during a movie or documentary. Inside Final Cut, titles can be as simple as a slate graphic for your production, or as complex as a fully animated motion graphic. Now, when you add a title as a connected clip, the underlying clip works as a background, meaning there's no need to composite further. Titles in Final Cut Pro work a lot like titles in iMovie, but offer a lot more in terms of properties and controls. In this movie, we'll become more familiar with how we can adjust and manipulate titles in the viewers and inspector. Now, to use titles in Final Cut Pro, first, take your playhead to where you'd like to have your title start. I'll move the title to the first frame of my clip, identified by the L on the lower left of my viewer. I'll head to the top left of my interface and either click on the titles and generator sidebar or use the shortcut Command Option 1. Since titles is selected, all of the titles that I have installed will show up in this window, including third-party titles. I can restrict the titles that I see by heading to the disclosure triangle to the left of the word titles, and then choosing a subcategory. Currently, I'm on built-in out. Now, in order to preview a title, let me first scroll to the top of this section. You can skim over that title to get a sense for it, like I am doing here with Dramatic, followed by Mondrian. And once you find a title that you'd like to bring in this case, I want to bring in Line Reveal, you can simply double-click it, and it will start to where you had your playhead positioned. Now, titles can be any length. If you select a title, you can press Ctrl-D to discover its duration at the bottom of the viewer. To change the duration, simply type in what you'd like it to be. In this case, I'll type in 5 period for 5 seconds, followed by the Enter key. Since it's a little shorter than my clip, I'll select the title's out point and drag it out. Now we can start to make changes to our title directly in the viewer. I'm going to double click the word text in order to have it all highlighted. And now in all capital letters, type in the word paradise. In order to move to the next title, I'll use the arrows at the top left of the viewer. I'll click on the right arrow and now type in my subtitle, An Undiscovered Land. To exit text entry mode, simply press Command Return. In order to make additional changes to my title, I'll open up the inspector by pressing Command 4. It brings me to the text inspector. Here, I can change the title's font, which is by default at Helvetica. In fact, if I click on the word Helvetica while holding down the mouse, I can scroll through multiple types of fonts in order to preview them. I want to select the font Oswald that's installed on my system. If I press the O key, I'll move there. I'll move to the O section. And now select Oswald from the list. I'd like to keep the first text as Oswald regular, but change the weight of the second text, so I'll select it. And now, since this one text layer is selected, I will make a change to just that, setting it to light. Now, in order to make universal changes to this text again, I'll choose Deselect All. Currently, I'm going to adjust the size of this text by scrolling in this field. We see two dashes because there are two different sizes for our text. Right now, the undiscovered land is getting cut off, but we'll fix that by first of all selecting the paradise text and dragging it up. We can see that the undiscovered land text is getting cut off, but I'll just drag that down so it doesn't happen, so that it matches roughly the length of the paradise text above. In order to move the entire text, I can actually head to the video inspector and then adjust the position of the entire text box. If I head back to the text inspector, there's a lot more that we can do with our text. In fact, if I scroll down, I have options for adjusting the face of my text, applying an outline, a glow, and even a drop shadow. I'd like to apply a drop shadow, but to my overall text, so I'll deselect all, and then click on the drop shadow button to apply it to both pieces of text. Now I'll click on the word show to see the properties of the drop shadow. In this instance, I will lower its opacity so it's subtle to 30%, increase the blur to 15, and then the distance to 10. You can use the tab key to move between these fields. Since I'm done with these changes, I'll hide this And I'll just select my undiscovered land and move it a little bit closer to the paradise. Text. Say you'd like to try a different title style for your project. One thing that you can do is easily replace titles that have the same amount of text fields. This has two, and if I head into the Motion MTitle Cinematic 2 category, I'm going to select the MTitle Cinematic 13 title and drag it directly over the template inside my timeline. Once I see a plus icon, I'll release my mouse. And since I want to have it match the length of that template, I'll choose Replace from Start. We can see here that that title now matches the length of the previous one. I'll select the paradise text, and we can see here that we get some on-screen controls that we can take advantage of. I will click on the circle and drag out to make this title much bigger. And in the middle of the circle in order to drag this title up. I'll now double click to select the paradise text layer, increase the title size, so it's the same length as the undiscovered land. Once I'm finished, I'll press Command Return to exit out of that text entry mode. Now, besides options for changing the stylistic properties of our text, we also have animated options that we can control for certain text templates. In order to see this, we need to head to the title inspector. In this template, we can see that we have options for turning off the animation that happens at the beginning and end of our text. Let's preview that first by selecting the text in our timeline and then pressing the forward slash key. Since I don't want an end animation for my title, I will click on the animation out on off checkbox. And now I'll also slow down the animation at the beginning of this title by entering a lower value. In this case, I'll set it to 1. Selecting my title again in the timeline and pressing the forward slash key, I can see a preview of that title. Besides the animation controls, the title inspector sometimes also includes additional properties that you can take advantage of, especially if there are additional graphics contained within your text template. Now, if this is a title that I would like to use over and over again, one thing I could do is right-click it inside the Titles and Generator sidebar and choose to make this as a default title. I could do the same thing with a lower third. If I now move my playhead to a new position in the timeline where I'd like to apply that same title template, select my MTitle Cinematic 13 title, and then from the edit menu under Connect Title, MTitle Cinematic 13 is now my default title that I can click to add it or press Control T, the shortcut. Now that's applied in the timeline. I'll press Command Z to undo that. Let's review all of this information. Titles are a great way to convey information to our audience. Now in Final Cut, we add titles from our Titles and Generator sidebar, which is currently selected. Titles can be easily added into our timeline by double-clicking once you've selected it or pressing the Q key. If I move my playhead directly over the title and now double-click the text inside the viewer, I can now make a change to that text layer. You can also use the controls on the upper left-hand corner to navigate between the various text layers that are part of the template. In the text inspector, we have options for changing the font as well as weight and size of our text, not to mention stylistic properties such as the face, outline, glow, and drop shadow. Certain text templates also contain animation properties which can be accessed in the title inspector. Simply head there to make changes to those animation controls. Your favorite lower thirds or main titles by right-clicking them and choosing to make default title or make default lower third. That would allow you to apply a title to your timeline with a shortcut key.